Hi, Pearls. It's Dr. Mimi Guarneri, and it's June 5th, 2020. What a week it has been. We have been working hard here in the clinic, and we are seeing many of you coming in feeling anxious, stressed, saddened, and even some people have come in depressed. This has been a tough week for the media, it's been a tough week watching the news, and it's been a tough week for us to realize that we still have major, major challenges in our country as it relates to racism and health disparities, and disparities in general. Last week, I had a woman come to see me, and she said that she's never drinks wine, and for the first time ever, she's drinking alcohol every night. You know, many of you have read my book, 108 Pearls, and I always talk about ways that we can transform our thinking. And we can watch the news all day long and go into breaking news and anxiety and sadness. Or we can watch a small tidbit of the news so we know what's going on, and we can fill our mind with thoughts of gratitude, with thoughts of acceptance, and to do things that are positive. So I'd like for us to think about a couple of our pearls as they relate to how we transform the stress response, because that seems to be what we need this week. We're not going to transform the stress response by eating more food and drinking more alcohol. We're going to transform the stress response by breathing. Remember to take a breath in, 5 seconds in, and 5 seconds out. We're going to transform our stress response by walking in nature. We're going to feel good by helping our neighbors, by bringing food to someone who needs it. We're going to feel purposeful by volunteering. We're going to feel purposeful by giving to a food bank. I invite you on Saturdays to join us for Kundalini Yoga on Zoom, and to go to the Pacific Pearl website to receive Rowney's free affirmations every day. Things are challenging right now, but many, many years ago, I met Reverend Shula, and Reverend Shula said this. He once had to give a speech when the economy and the finances were completely downturned, and he had to go and speak to a group of unemployed individuals. And he said, I had no idea, Dr. G, what I was going to say when I got on that stage. He said, and as I was walking, the thought occurred to me that tough times don't laugh, but tough people do. The concept that tough times don't last, they don't last, but tough people do. And that's been one of the mottos of our country. So tomorrow is D-Day. It's a reminder that freedom is not free. And we have to remember that we will never be free until we're free to love who we want to love, practice the religion that we want to practice, and say what we need to say. The ability to peacefully protest, to bring people who do egregious things to justice, and to say what we need to say without being persecuted, are American values. And that's what it means to live in a democracy. At Pacific Pearl La Jolla, we believe in the healing power of love, and I invite you to send love to our world, which so desperately needs it.